Knowing the history of Pokemon, generally the stories have been more on the tame side, following the story of a 10-year-old kid beginning their journey through their selective region, training and fighting through the gym leaders of said region, and claiming the title Pokemon League Champion after currently defeating the reigning one. Plain and simple, right? Though, with the release of Generation 5, the main story of Pokemon started to become a little bit darker. Darker tones and having players question their moralities. Though you could argue Pokemon has always had a darker tone embedded in it thanks to items and places you're able to investigate in the games, and as most people know too, that the side Pokemon games have a much greater dark tone to them, as I personally feel that Game Freak does, because they know most kids won't go out of their way to play those random Pokemon games. But that's the thing. Let's just imagine for a moment, what if after the release of the probably the most lighthearted Pokemon games, those being the Let's Go games, Game Freak delivers us Pokemon Generation 8, the darkest generation of Pokemon. Now keep in mind, this story was completely written by me, and I want you all to go in with an open mind, as it's nothing that we've ever experienced before. And this game, of course, would have completely different Pokemon, but for the sake of this video and my unoriginality, I'm going to replace the random Pokemon names with Pokemon we already know and love. But with that being said, this is the darkest generation of Pokemon, Pokemon Generation 8. The protagonist of our story is the newly 10-year-old Sigma, who's finally ready to begin his Pokemon journey as he finishes his breakfast and takes his dishes to the sink. The television catches his attention to the news channel covering a developing story on the criminal organization who's been terrorizing civilians and trainers alike, and have even been heard to kill them alongside their Pokemon. Sounds pretty scary. But I'll have my Pokemon soon, I'll be the strongest in the world. Being concerned, Sigma's mother hesitates on letting him go, but presumably knowing their town is full of powerful trainers and law enforcement officers, I'm assuming she feels it'd be detrimental mental life decision to stop him now. Sending me off with her love and prayers, I set off to the Alcove City, where Professor Evergreen's Pokemon Research Lab is located. Upon his arrival, me being in an unfamiliar city alone, only accompanied by my map leading to Evergreen's lab, it's a bit intimidating. It's also quite apparent that the city's had its share of recent commotion, as there's been at least 6 or so Officer Jennies passed by since I've gotten here. It's great to see how diligent they are. With that, finally, Professor Evergreen's lab. Upon entering Evergreen's lab, I was greeted by the assistant who led me to the lab area, where waiting for me were 5 others around my age, also itching to meet their first partner Pokemon. Now that everyone who is scheduled to arrive has made it here, Professor Evergreen goes into detailed lecture about the world of Pokemon and how it should be respected and treated with care, and something about Pokemon being dangerous when accompanied by dangerous people. It was honestly pretty boring, but that reminded me of school. I just want to meet my new friend already. After a little longer, the speech concluded and we were introduced to our starter Pokemon. After showing them off to each other and doing a few sparring matches with each other, the professor urged us to listen to his final request. Apparently, throughout the Silver region, there's been a criminal organization going around trying to hurt people and their Pokemon for being weak. Because of how dangerous them and their ghost-type Pokemon are, he urged us to become as strong as we can and find friends to stick with us. I didn't know why he seemed so flustered. I'm a Pokemon master now. Nothing could get stronger than me. And with that, we received our Pokedexes and headed out back to Alcove City and went our separate ways. I went around and explored the town for a while until Torchic and I got hungry and set out for some food. And once our bellies were full, I remembered a Pokemon master has got to keep up with his training so no one can claim my throne. So Torchic and I found our way to this abandoned house just outside of Alcove City, where I'd eventually make my second castle. We explored the upstairs and downstairs of the house, and it was all dusty and old. We definitely can't have this stuff lying around my castle. So I started to take off books from the shelf, and when all of a sudden a blaring alarm started going off. It was so loud I couldn't even hear myself think. What the heck? What's going on? I tried pushing the book back into its spot, but it was stuck in place somehow. That's when I noticed the windows became barricaded with these metal poles, and they wouldn't open anymore. I ran with Torchic back downstairs to escape out the front door when I saw 2 shadowy figures looming in front of the door. That's impossible. There was no one else here. What Pokemon are these? The Pokedex registered them as Gengar and Dusclops, but they weren't alone. 2 people dressed in black and gray walked out of the dark alongside them. What are you doing here, kid? Don't you know it's rude to go wandering around where your stupid self doesn't belong? I'm not a kid. I'm Pokemon Master Sigma. Pokemon Master? You? What are you, 10? And in that moment, the man dashed and punched me in the face. The next thing I knew, I was crashing into the staircase behind me. What the heck? What are these guys? Torchic, get him! Use your scratch attack! Torchic then leaped with great speed and attacked the Dusclops, but phased right through it. Huh? How is that possible?
You really don't get it, you snot-nosed brat, do you? Dusclops, use Shadow Ball!
The monster Pokemon created a giant orb of dark energy and launched it point-blank at Torchic. Torchic!
Do you see now? Do you see why you insects don't deserve to be on this beautiful planet of ours? You weaklings are infesting this place and making our society grow weaker by the day. He says as he walks towards me. The man stomped his foot into my stomach with all his might. Do you see how weak you are? If you were strong enough, you could have escaped this place with your little pet and been about your merry way, or at least have put up a decent scrap. But instead, let me show you what Team Void does to little pests like you and that rat of yours. Olivia, show him.
No, stop, please, I'm begging you. I can get strong, I will. Please, just let him go, mister.
Go on, shut up, you maggot.
The woman shouts, Gengar, Mega Evolve.
Then in a vibrant glow of light, Gengar transforms into something totally different.
Gengar, use Shadow Ball and kill this rat. No!
Then in a wave of darkness, the house shook and nothing could be seen. It's as if I'd been thrown into the void. Slowly my sense of hearing returned as I heard the squeal of Torchic, and then there was silence.
Torchic!
I pushed the man with all my might and stumbled across the lobby and held Torchic in my arms.
It's gonna be okay, Torchic. There's a Pokemon Center nearby. All we just have to do is just make it there. You have to hold on.
Where do you think you're headed, twerp? You didn't think you'd be leaving alive, did you? Let me show you how kids these days need to be punished.
I had to think fast. I noticed that the blast from Gengar created a small hole behind Torchic's body. I didn't want to do it. I swear I didn't want to, but I had to. I left Torchic's body behind and fled out the small hole. I ran as fast as I could back into town. I don't believe they were following me. They likely had to deactivate the security system that trapped us in there because those people were definitely too big to fit through the hole like I did. I sat back in an alley, taking refuge there as it began to rain. Those were the guys from the news. Team Void. The professor tried to warn me. He tried. And I had to leave Torchic behind. I couldn't hold back the tears as I'd imagine everything different that could have happened. What if Torchic and I both could have fit? What if I left with the other kids and didn't go off alone? What if Torchic was still alive and now he's trapped there with Team Void? So many different things. I couldn't help but bury my face to hide my tears, and my heart shattered and its remains fell into the void. It's been 8 years since that day. 8 years since the event that happened with Team Void. I've since retreated to the refuge that is my house, and my mom has been taking care of me, taking me to my doctor, helping me take my meds. She's a real lifesaver. It kills me that her life's been set on pause thanks to her good-for-nothing son. I finally decided to make a small step of recovery today and go grab some milk from the store. Alright, that wasn't too bad. Wish there wasn't so many creepy-looking people around, though. I better get home fast. But before I knew it, the rain came pouring down. I was running as quickly as I could until a thud on my back made me fall forward and drop everything I had. Ugh, what the heck was that? And then my heart sank, and my breath silenced. To me, even the rain was silent. As I turned around, and there stood a man with a familiar black and gray uniform with a purple Vortex logo in the center. Team Void?
You're in our way, you loser, the man said.
Please don't hurt me. Take my money, my bag, whatever you want. Just please don't hurt.
Jeez, shut up, you pathetic insect. Your voice gives me a headache. This is why you good-for-nothing weaklings should just die. Chandelure, let's burn this bug.
No! Piplup, use water gun!
As the cloud of steam dissipates, there was a guy crouched beside me with his hand extended.
You okay? Who are you?
Me?
Oh, right, I'm Chase.
Hey, you brat! What do you think you're Before I could think, Piplup sprang with great speed and headbutt the grunt in the stomach. Screw you! You'll pay for this, you worm! As he ran off into the forest.
Ah, that's better. Hey, I'm glad you're okay.
How did you do that? Weren't you scared?
Huh? Scared? I didn't even think about it, if I'm being honest. I saw you in trouble and Piplup and I wanted to help.
I couldn't do that. I'm not strong enough.
Well, hey, no one starts off strong, people or Pokemon. But when you work together to become strong, you'll end up twice as strong.
For real? I can be strong? But Torchic.
Yeah, sometimes we're scared when we make mistakes, and those we care about can get hurt. Well, that's why we become strong, to prevent these things from happening again. Becoming strong enough to protect those that matter.
That's when it struck me.
I can't wallow in shame for the mistakes I've made in the past. I can't keep being weak and being a burden to those risking themselves for me. I have to become strong and become an image of strength to inspire those around me to become stronger too, so everyone can protect those that they love. And with that, I strapped up. No more weakling Sigma. This is for you, Torchic. I captured a Pokemon, trained him as we alongside my team conquered all 8 gym leaders, foiling the plans of Team Void along the way, until it was my turn to challenge the Elite Four. There were many times I truly felt we were done for, but the look on my Pokemon's faces, they trusted me, and I trusted them, which led to us facing the Pokemon League champion, Chase. With every passing moment, seconds felt like hours, minutes felt like days, until both parties' final Pokemon were clashing. Every bit of trainers and Pokemon's minds in sync. It was a long fight, seemingly never ending at first until Chase's Pokemon collapsed. Though we seemed disappointed, Chase never frowned and gave me the biggest smile he could give and told me he told me so. And now I sit on the throne of Pokemon League champion, and that is how I became the strongest trainer in the world. Now I know some of you guys probably began thinking sometime during this video, this was awesome, but definitely wouldn't happen in a Pokemon game. But you know, at the end of the day, I guess that's not what this is all really about. As a current Pokemon fan, or even an old school Pokemon fan, it's nice to imagine what could be, just for the sake of entertainment and seeing a unique perspective. Heck, even the manga had Pokemon getting sliced in half. So to those of you who stuck around to the end and watched with an open mind, thank you. If you enjoyed the video, hitting the bell after subscribing will make sure you never miss a video again. Thank you all so much for watching. My name is Kingdom Ace, and remember, my loyal knights, to always look skyward.